Hey guys, it's Miss Jordan, and today we're going to continue talking about the fruits of the Spirit. So far, we've learned about love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, and now we're on gentleness. So gentleness is a word that sometimes when we use it, we think that gentleness means weakness. But I want to tell you guys today, it actually means the opposite. I don't think someone can be gentle unless they're actually pretty strong. But to explain this, I have Odin and then I have a small dog named Finn. Now Finn, whenever he was little, if he jumped on you, it didn't make a difference. He was pretty small, his claws aren't huge, it didn't hurt as bad. Now Odin, if he jumps on somebody, it's gonna hurt. He's taller than me, his claws are big, his paws are massive, and he's a pretty big boy. Like, his head is the same size as mine. So if he jumps on somebody, it's gonna hurt. So with Odin, we have to teach him the word gentle, and we've had to teach him how to be calm and how to be gentle because he is so strong and he is so big. So when we talk about gentleness, I don't want us to think it means weakness, but it means to learn how to control our strength and to use our power for good. So if we have Christ, we have power in us, and we have the power to change things for the people around us. We can change people's lives, we can change people's days. We have power in us given to us by Jesus Christ and by having the Holy Spirit in us. So we have to learn how to use this for good and to be gentle with the ways that we approach people. Also, the Bible tells us that we have to speak the truth all the time, but it says to do so in love and gentleness. How do we do that? Well, that means if somebody, say they don't believe in Jesus and they believe something else besides what the Bible says, and so instead of going to them and being like, hey, you need to believe in Jesus, it's really dumb that you would believe something besides what the Bible says, we can go to them and be like, hey, would you like to come to church with me? We have a lot of fun. And I would really love for you to learn about the Jesus that I serve. But also we can sit and just talk to them and be easy with our words. So we can be gentle with our words, but we can also be gentle with our actions. There are some people that maybe they've never felt love before. And we can be gentle with them and show them love and kindness and show them that God loves them through the way that we treat them and the way that we are gentle and careful with the ways that we act towards the people around us. So Jesus is a prime example of gentleness. Now, is Jesus weak? No. So when we think about gentleness, we know it doesn't have to mean weakness, because Jesus, it calls him meek and gentle. And he says that we can come to him because his yoke is easy and he is gentle. So how was Jesus gentle? How about when Jesus was dying on the cross? He was spit on, he was beat, he had his clothes taken from him. Could Jesus at any point of time, could he have come off the cross? Could he have beat those people? Yes, Jesus is all powerful. He can do whatever he wants. He could have retaliated. Could he have said something back to those people that were mocking him? Yes, but you know what he didn't say? He said, Father, please forgive them, for they know not what they do. Jesus was gentle in a situation like that, so I'm pretty sure we can be gentle in the situations that we come across this week and this month. So another way that Jesus was gentle was how he dealt with people when they messed up. You and I both have people in our lives that are gonna mess up. Do we mess up ourselves? All the time. And we're gonna have people in our lives that do the same, because we're human, and that's what happens when we're not perfect. So how do we treat people when they mess up? One time some people brought a lady to Jesus, and she had messed up pretty bad, and they were expecting Jesus to stone her. They were expecting him to tell them to punish her. And you know what Jesus did? He didn't do any of that. He forgave her, and he helped her up, and he didn't condemn her. He was gentle with her, and he sent them in a way and told them that they shouldn't condemn her either. So this is how we treat people that mess up. We're gentle with them, we forgive them, we love them, and we treat them like Jesus would. So this week, think about how is it that you can be gentle with the way that you treat people, the way you talk to people, and the way that you interact with people. Remember, you have a lot of power, and with great power comes great responsibility. So it's your responsibility to be gentle with what you have. If you think about a superhero would have a lot of power. But if they didn't know how to control their power and they weren't gentle with it, it could do a lot of bad. Think about Elsa before she knew how to control her powers. She hurt her sister because she didn't know how to control what she had. So we have to make sure that we are being gentle and learn to kind of control the power that we have so we're not hurting the people around us either. The way that we can do this is to ask the Holy Spirit to help us this week, because He's the only way that we can be acting like Jesus is by letting the Holy Spirit take over and to help us. I love y'all so, so much. I hope y'all are having a fantastic week, and we will see y'all next week. Bye, guys.